What's up everyone, I'm Chirag and welcome to part 2 of the tutorial series on AWS HTTP API. So guys, in the previous tutorial we had gone through the feature difference between the HTTP API and the REST API, and now in this tutorial we will go through the creation of the HTTP API and we will have a high level look at its components. So let's get started. So assuming that you already have logged in into AWS Management Console, and once you are there, click on Services, look for API Gateway and click on that. And once you are within API Management Console, click on Create API from the top right corner. Now here we need to choose the API type. So here we have multiple API types, but since we are dealing with HTTP API, so we will click on Build. You can also import if you have specs, right? So for now, we will click on Build. Now here, we need to enter the API name. So here I will quickly say HTTP API. And then here we have integration. So it gives us an option to add integration at the time of creation. But at this point, we can only create integration with Lambda function or public HTTP endpoints. And to create integration with like private resources in a VPC or AWS services, we need to create the API first and then we can create those integration. So what we are going to do here is we will leave it as it is. We are not going to add any integration. We will do it later. Now here after the API name and the integration, here we have two options. Either we can click on next or either we can click on review and create. So review and create will basically take you to the step 4, right? And it will skip the step 2 and step 3, but we will click on next from here. Here we will see, here we can configure routes. So basically API Gateway uses routes to expose integration of the API, and routes for HTTP APIs consist of two parts. That is basically the HTTP method. So it could be get, post, put, patch, head, option, and delete, and a resource path, right? So resource path could be anything like your API endpoint, URL slash patch store or slash delete or insert, whatever, right? So that's basically configure routes over here. So since we have not integrated anything in the step 1, so that's the reason the add route button is disabled. So now we will click on next. So here we have configured stages. So you can create a new stage from here. By default, there is one stage, that is default stage. And by default, auto deploy is enabled. So whatever changes you make in the HTTP API, it's going to get auto deployed. So you don't need to explicitly deploy that API like we do in the REST API. So here also we are going to leave all this as it is, and then finally we will click on next and we will say create. Here we are. So we successfully created the HTTP API named as HTTP API, and here we have API details over here, API ID, protocol, default endpoint enabled, and we didn't have any description and the creation date. After that we have stages for the HTTP API. So as I mentioned, there is one default stage that is being automatically created. So here is that default stage, and this is our invocation URL. So what happens in REST API, we don't get the invocation URL until and unless we don't explicitly deploy that API. So here by default, we have the invocation URL. So that is basically auto deployed functionality. And then we have tags. So right now we had not added any tags. So you can do that later. So now we will go through the left panel. So here under develop, we have routes. So right now we don't have any route, but you can click on create and choose the method. So as I mentioned, routes for HTTP APIs consist of two parts. That is the HTTP method. So this is our HTTP method from which you can select appropriate method, maybe post for example. And here you can give the resource path. So it could be store or slash data, or it could be anything. And then you can click on create. So that's basically routes. Let's navigate to authorization. So within authorization, we don't see anything since we have not created any route. Let's go to manage authorizers. So here we have the IAM built-in authorizer for HTTP API. And apart from that, HTTP APIs also support AWS Lambda authorizer. So if I click on create, so it gives us two options, that is AWS Lambda or the JWT token authorization. So here HTTP API supports native OpenID Connect and OAuth 2.0, and it also supports Amazon Cognito, but you can only use AWS Cognito as a JWT token issuer, So that's basically authorizer. So obviously we are going to go through all this functionality step by step in the upcoming tutorials. So this is a very high level overview that I wanted to give and what all it have in the console as an option. Now let's navigate to integrations. So integrations are nothing but the backend functionality that we attach. So it could be HTTP endpoint or it could be a Lambda function that we will certainly attach with the routes that we will configure or create. So right now we don't have any routes as I mentioned earlier. So here we have it blank. Now let's go to manage integration. So here we can create the integration. To create the integration, we need to select the route and the integration target. So now here you can see, apart from Lambda function and the HTTP backend, we have other options like private resources and other AWS services like EventBridge, SQS, AppConfig, Kinesis and Step function. So these are the services that are available as a part of the backend integration. But if we look at the REST API, we have a lot more option as a part of the AWS services in terms of integration, right? So these are the integration list that you can go with HTTP API. Now let's navigate to cores. So HTTP API comes with built-in support for cores. So that's over here. So here you can configure the cross-origin resource sharing. But in REST API, we used to manually enable cores and configure that. But here we get cores as an inbuilt option within HTTP API. Then we have Reinport. If you have open API 3 definition, then you can use that specification to import that API. And then you can also export this HTTP API endpoint in the form of JSON or YAML. So it would be in open API 3 definition, obviously. Right, so that's basically under develop. Now let's look at the deploy. So deploy has only one thing, that is stage. And as we know that there is a default or auto deployment enabled, and due to that we have some default stage already created for us, but we can create multiple stage like dev, prod or whatever, test environment stage. So that's basically stage. So you can create it from here. Now let's look at the protect. Within protect we have throttling. So if you want to limit the number of requests or the concurrent request, so all those things you can handle from the throttling part. So we can select the stage from here default, and we can say select, and here it will give you some options. So we can do some route level throttling, and then we have default throttling and the account level throttling, right? So account level throttling is kind of a burst limit is 5,000 and rate limit is 10,000, right? Then we have monitor. Within monitor we have metrics. So here we can have route metrics, and here we can select the route and we will have the relevant metrics from here. And then finally we have logging. So by default access logging is disabled. So to enable that you need to create a CloudWatch log group and paste the URN of that over here. So if I click on edit and enable access logging, it will ask me the CloudWatch log group ARN that we need to paste here as we used to do in the REST API. So that's basically a very high level of what HTTP API consoles and its components looks like, and a very, very high level introduction, I could say, of each of the components. So that's all I wanted to cover in this tutorial. And as usual, till that time, if you want me to do a tutorial on any use case or service, then please leave them below and I will try my best to come up with a tutorial as soon as possible. And if you have any queries or comments, then again, please leave them below and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, and see you next time.